Two-pack base coat, clear coat is often a closely guarded secret. Not too many people share. There's plenty of stuff on YouTube, and it's guys in spray booths, and all you see them doing is working their spray gun. They're not actually telling you what's happening. So a good way to practice, or a good way to learn, and you can do it for keeps, is to perhaps paint some of the cabinetry or the doors in your shed, or your cupboards or your drawers. Really cool thing, I've got a fridge, two fridges. There's the main fridge in the house, and this is my beer fridge, or extra food fridge. And so I've taken the doors off, and I'm going to base coat, clear coat it, and give you guys a demonstration and a few hot tips. So this is the bottom fridge door. It's been primed in my favorite primer filler. Yeah. Your first coat, I've already done. There's no point in watching you spray. First coat, this was a U-Pol primer, blocked down. It was wax and grease remover, and then it was wax and grease remover, and then it was use the tack rag on it to take off any dust. And like painting anything, you paint around inside all your edges or your underneath all your awkward bits first. And then your first coat is actually quite light. It acts as your base, or what will stick to. So you don't go for a full wet coat or a 50% overlap with your gun like you normally do. Yeah, first coat, I just went for it, just lay down one full pass and then drop down a full pass and come across there. So you can see it's quite opaque, but this will bite into the primer and will still not be fully dry, so it will be quite sticky for me to actually lay down the next wet coat on. Again, with metallics and pearl micas, and particularly with base coat, always spray first onto a test piece. You can't just go straight on there and expect that you've got all the right settings, so you've got your right amount of paint flow and your right amount of airflow, which will set the size of your fan. The distance from the work is still the same rule as always. It's about a hand span away. Yeah, you'd have a fan about as wide as your hand again, probably, maybe a bit narrower, depending how much gun control practice you've got. And the rule is, everything stays at 90 degrees. The gun must remain at 90 degrees, not on an angle like that, completely square on, and at exactly the same distance. The reason being is that if you're spraying along or over the work, and you tip over this way, the metallics, or if you're spraying a pearl mica, they're a diamond-shaped flake. They'll actually fall over, they won't stand on their edge. So you can get a really good, solid, even metallic coming through the colour if you stay exactly the same distance and exactly square to the work all the way as you work your way along. Coming back further causes them to fall over or sit differently, and having the gun over on an angle will also cause those problems. So there's a tip or a secret. So your first coat's quite light, it's opaque, you can see through it. And gun distance and angle is critical for the micas or the metallics to all be even. Second hot tip, base coat will always dry flat. You know how previous paints you're used to using dulons or enamels, they're glossing, they gloss all the way as you go. Base coat dries flat. 20 degrees Celsius is what we go by here, or Europeans normally use, not American, but whatever that temperature is for you guys. You obey your drying time, so that would be at least 15 minutes, a minimum, at 20 degrees. Maybe longer if the day's not so hot. Yeah, there's no hurry, plenty of time, you can go half an hour or more. Now once that's dry, and it looks all flat like this in the first coat, you can do this through all the stages. You might have had a run where you've overlapped somewhere, you've gone along one way and come back the other way. Base coat runs real easy, but it's not a problem. Go in with your 800 grit sandpaper, and your wax and grease remover as your lubricant, and you can go right in here and just after 20 minutes, half an hour, you can just block down. You can actually see the base coat, you can see the metallics trying to shine through there where I've cut them off with the sandpaper. So I can just go through and I can rub out the run that I got here in the corner. When it's time to go again, I'm going to do my second coat. I'm going to come in like this. Again, you'll have to adjust the spray pattern. But we'll wind in the flow and the air. Testing on my test paper. So now I've just got the small amount here. Just pulling the gun part way back. Should have my respirator on, be a good boy. So you put this one on. Look after your lungs. This is full of cyanide, which will kill you progressively over time. You go in and you just spot that. And then the... Just sit there and hold the gun on with just the air going through to dry that off.
So go back, spot touch it up, or spot colour that area, hold the gun on it, let it dry, and then you'll come back and do a full second coat over the whole panel.
Base coat, second coat. Again, it will dry flat. I've been a body shop man or doing restoration all of my life, and the hardest thing to do is to put the coat down and walk away. Obey the time between even longer. Like I said, 20 degrees, 15 minutes. You can walk away for half an hour, three quarters of an hour, and then come back and put the second coat on. Again, wait that same time period, put the third coat on, okay? This is where we touched up before. Still a little bit opaque, but won't have any problems going over that again with the third coat. So, done the third coat of base coat. So the secrets or the rules is wait as you can patiently wait between coats. Three coats of base. Again, it dries satin, completely flat, no gloss, no sign of any metallic, nothing's happening. This is just how base coat is. I'm ready to clear coat. I've gone in after an hour, 2 hours. You wait for this to dry into one uniform base colour, the three coats. And then you can even leave this overnight if you wanted to. I'm teaching you the basics. If this was a hot rod, we could flat this down and put another two coats of base over the already flatted down to make it a super slick finish. But just the basics. Three coats, 45 minutes between coats. And I've gone in now, any blemishes, any dirt or dust or anything that's fallen on here, 1500 grit, again with a little bit of wax and grease remover, and just gently knock the top off whatever may have fallen on top of here, or dust or imperfections that may have got into it. And so, wait a couple of hours, wait overnight, it's time to clear coat. This is the first coat of clear. It's treated pretty much like the first coat of base coat. There isn't a 50% overlap, there isn't much overlapping happening at all. It goes on what looks to be reasonably dry and hairy, but this is where the amazing part of base coat clear coat comes together. You can just, if you look down here on the edges, you can see where it went on a little bit wet, and you can actually see the colour behind it and the metallic starting to come through. That's your first coat of clear. It needs to be completely dry, so you're touching it to see if that's fully dry. If it's touched dry, then you're ready for your second coat. On top of that, when your second coat's just stringy or tacky, you can feel it on your masking or in a place where you won't see it, on goes your third coat. Alright? So these are the rules of base coat, clear coat. I've finished spraying. I put a third coat on. So first coat looked dry. Second coat was wet. Third coat went on nice and wet. I waited, and it wasn't really that sticky, and I just threw a little bit more thinners in the last of the clear that I had, just to thin it down so it sat even flatter. And this is the finished result. No spray booth, no tint or anything in here, just clear coat straight over the base coat. You can now see the metallic comes through, the whole paint sits nice and flat, and I'll come back later, might give this a couple of days, anywhere 2 days to 2 weeks. I'll 1500 grit it with soapy water, and then I'll be able to mop and polish any of the dust that's landed in the clear coat since I painted it. And that's pretty much how you, pretty much the basics of base coat, clear coat. And, so have some fun. Practice at home. Do some cabinets or some units or some benches or some cupboards. Or grab your refrigerator or your beer fridge and give it a paint job. Every time you go to get yourself a beer, you'll get the job satisfaction of seeing the base coat, clear coat, all shiny and super flat and smooth. See ya.